My name is Don J. Smith. I'm the chairman of the Board of Trustees of the Community Theater, and I'm standing in front of a 100-year-old house that was located on the property at 9 Pine Street, a piece of property that is directly behind the Community Theater, a piece of property that we bought in 1995 when we bought the theater. We have been forced into this situation of having to vacate the property because of the need for a backstage loading area and development for the backstage of the theater. The Vail Mansion next door is being developed, and the new owners have said we can no longer use their property to move our trucks and buses for the artists and for the performances. We were faced with the prospect of having to demolish this century-old colonial-style home, but because it's located in the historic district and is considered a contributing building in the historic district, the New Jersey Historic Sites Council reluctantly gave us permission to demolish the house only if we offered it for sale to a buyer who was willing to move the house and restore it. That buyer stepped forward. Peter Kaforis, the owner of London World Connection, stepped forward to buy the home for a dollar, and here we are now in the middle of the move. The house will be relocated on 10 to Hart Street, and the Community Theater will have the opportunity to construct its loading dock and backstage facility. It's a happy ending for the town. It's a happy ending for this wonderful home and for everyone involved. Thank you.
History has been saved in Morristown.
As News 12 New Jersey's Mike Forrest tells us, it's taking a transplanted Englishman to transplant a very old house.
This is Peter Kaforis, the owner of the London World Connect Hair Salon in Morristown. And this is the 107-year-old building that was facing demolition until Peter stepped in front of the wrecking ball. For just a buck, he bought the building. Just so long as the township would allow him to move it here, just across the street from his current location.
We're all behind him, and certainly it reflects a passion that we all have for the Victorian architecture in Morristown, the preservation, and I applaud Peter for what he's doing.
And don't think Peter's getting everything for just that one buck.
Well, actually, it's going to cost $55,000 just to move it. It's going to cost approximately $15,000 to take down the electric wires. We've got a few lampposts, which we've got to drop the arms.
Added together, that's $70,000, and he expects to spend $500,000 more renovating the old building before moving his 1,400-square-foot salon into a new 3,000-square-foot luxury spa.
We're going to enjoy restoring this building, and the town is being 100% behind us.
Personally, I want to thank him from the bottom of my heart. As mayor, I also want to thank him, and we're going to be rooting for him and helping him in his business because he really has stepped up to the plate.
So if all goes as planned, by the end of July, this building will have moved 2.5 blocks from here to here. In Morristown, Mike Forrest, News 12, New Jersey.
Like they used to say on the A-Team, don't you just love it when a plan comes together?
Plans to make it a spa and thinks historic Morristown is a perfect place to do it.
Well, I think Morristown is probably the place to have a building like this. I mean, coming from London myself, the amount of history that's in this town, I mean, basically, what, 300 years ago, you were hanging us guys, but won't get into that, but as I said, there is a lot of history in Morristown. That's probably one of the nicest places in North Jersey that I can think of.
Moving the historic house from behind the community theater will also allow both the theater and the proposed Vail Mansion Hotel to move forward with expansion plans. It is beautiful up there.
It is, and I'm glad he's let bygones be bygones from the Revolutionary War.
All those years ago.
Yeah.
salon owner is saving an historic home from demolition. News 12 New Jersey's Allie Bowder is there. So, Allie, how's moving day going?
Well, Letitia, so far so good. The house is about 30 by 50 feet, and it had to go down some pretty narrow streets. So it snapped a few trees, broke a few windows, but all in all, it's in pretty good shape.
When the house started to move off of the site, my knees were quaking. I wasn't sure the house was going to make it.
Easy does it. Stoplights are pulled down and crowds push back, making way for the grand lady.
Oh, this is fascinating. First time I've ever seen anything this exciting.
The fact that they can take it off the foundation and keep the structural integrity and move it along, so it's kind of fun.
The empty house is moving just over 1,000 feet, making some tricky turns.
We got to get down and we have to do a lot of calculations and make certain that, you know, you really want to go through with this.
Peter Kaforis really wants to go through with it. He's the proud new owner and bought it for a song, $1.
They would have demolished the house, and that really truly would be a crime to lose a building like this.
He had so many dreams and visions that I knew he was the right guy to come forward and save this house.
Peter is turning the house into a day spa after restoring it to its original grandeur.
The staircase is wonderful. It's actually in great shape, considering the house was sitting empty for almost 20 years, I've been told. We got some leaded glass, which we're going to save. We're going to really try and get it back to where it was.
Morristown has a long and proud history. Its people, its architecture, spanning many eras, Revolutionary, Gilded Age, and the Victorian, of which this is representative. Our historic inventory is so important to the town pride.
You erode your history a piece at a time. And one house doesn't seem so important, but in a town like Morristown, we have lost a lot of historic houses.
But they've made sure not this one.
107 years, that's two or three generations. That's a lot of time.
It is a lot of history, and it's a lot of house. As you can see behind me, they're still working on it. It's not a done deal. It's about a three-day process. Now, they're going to get it off the supports today, put it in this lot where we're standing now, and then tomorrow, they'll lay it on steel beams and build the foundation up to meet it. In Morristown, Allie Bowder, News 12, New Jersey.
You know, Allie, that's such an undertaking. How much does moving this house cost?
Well, the move, Letitia, cost Peter about $80,000 to $100,000, but there's no telling how much the renovations will cost, so he'll have to cut quite a bit of hair before he pays for that.
Okay, thank you very much, Allie. Nice job.
My name's Peter Kaforis. I'm with London World Connection Hair Salon Spa. I heard that the community theater had a project, and if somebody didn't move the house itself, it would have to be demolished. So what I did, I approached the chairman, Don Smith, with Paul Miller, who's head of the who's the vice president of the partnership, and Michael, who's the head of the partnership. And we actually spoke and came to the idea, now if I can find a location to place the house, I'd be interested in moving it. And First Union came forward and worked with me, and we managed to actually take the spot to my left here, which is a track of 50 feet by 188 feet. Which behind me you'll see the house on Dehart Street, which hopefully will be sitting there by tomorrow.
Thank you. huge historic home dodged the wrecking ball after one man jumped in to save the day.
Every time a building is destroyed, a piece of history is lost.
Today in Morristown, a bit of history was not lost. This three-story, 100-year-old house was scheduled to be torn down to make room for expansion of the community theater. Instead, it was bought for $1 by Peter Kaforis, an Englishman who owns a health spa. He's moving it to a new site.
There's a touch of irony that an Englishman is saving a piece of history in colonial Morristown.
The move is costing Kaforis between $80,000 and $100,000.
Which is a little more than we anticipated.
Another $60,000 was spent getting the house ready for the move. The porch had to be taken down, the interior plaster removed, then it was jacked up, placed on planks with huge wheels, and slowly, very slowly, moved down the street.
A lot of this stuff I didn't understand as he was telling me how he's going to do it, but now we're in DeHart Street, and it's looking great.
Kaforis plans to move his spa, the London World Connection, into the building, which was built around 1900. But only after careful renovation.
We're going to do a lot of homework, actually, try and figure out what they were doing at the turn of the century as far as color combination and so on, and we'll work with that.
And Kaforis says he hopes to have the new spa up and running by spring.